What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today I'm going to show you some of the new materials in V-Ray 3.4 for SketchUp. Let's get started. First, let's take a look at the new material editor. You can open it by first going to the V-Ray Asset Editor and click on this tab. Now if you click this arrow on the left side, you will see a built-in V-Ray materials library. This contains the basic materials such as car paint, glass, metal, etc. Click on a category to add it to the library and click it again to remove it from your library. Essentially, you can add multiple categories to your library by selecting one after another like this. You can also change how you view the materials with these buttons here and change the size of them here. Once you see a material you like, drag and drop it here to add it to the material list. You can then make changes to it through going to the Quick Settings tab. Or if you want to customize it even more, then click this arrow on the right to open up the advanced options. Let's go back to the material list. There are these buttons down here with different functions. These are pretty self-explanatory, so I just want to focus on this one right here, which is the Add Material button. This button will let you create new materials using built-in presets. There are a couple of new ones, so let's go through them. Number 1. Override Material. The override material allows a surface to look differently depending on whether it is seen through reflections, refractions, or GI. Let's try it on the scene. Here I have a rose and a mirror. It renders pretty nicely, but let's make it better. I really like the red, but let's say I want the rose color and the reflection to be blue. Then I can use the override material for that. First, click on the Add Material button and create an override material. Now you need to set the base material. For this case, I'll set it as the rose material that I was already using. And in the reflection material, I'll set it as rose 2, which is a blue glass material I created. Now what you need to do is repaint the object with the new override material. You can do this by first selecting all of the rose material with this option here, and now use the apply material to selection to paint all of those geometries with this new material. If it's done correctly, it will look like this. Pretty cool, huh? Number 2. Blend Material. The blend material can be used to layer several materials and create a more complex material. For example, I have two materials here. I can create a new material that perfectly blends these two by first creating a blend material, then set one of those materials as the base and the other as the coat. Now you can apply it to your geometry. Notice how the material shows up black in the model space? That's because SketchUp is confused by this material since it's a blend of two different materials. But if you hit the render button, it should come out just fine. You can also add a texture to the coat to control the blend. For example, I have two more materials here that I want to blend together, but let's try to add a checkered texture to the coat and see what happens. You can see that the coat is affected by the map that we added earlier, and the result is an awesome chessboard. Number 3. Stochastic Flicks. The stochastic material can be used to simulate a material that has a mirror-like flex scattered over the surface. We usually see it in car paint, MacBooks, and ornaments. Let's try it on this MacBook. Here you can see the render image with the default aluminum material that came with the model. It looks good, but let's see how it looks with the stochastic flex. As you can see, in some area, there's not much of a difference, especially when it's further away, but you can see more of the flex when it's closer up. If you want to colorize this material, go to the Color Flake Perimeter Swirlout and click on this drop-down. Select Color Flakes, Random from Map. Now check this box, select the color texture and set it to whatever you want. There you go, now you have a pink MacBook. You're welcome. Number 4. Bump Material. The bump material allows you to stack multiple bump maps together to create a more complex surface material. For example, here I have a cloth material with a fabric texture for the bump map. I can add more bump maps to this texture by using the bump material. First, click on this button and create a bump material. Now you can set the original material as the base and then add another bump map here. For this example, I'm going to use a grid texture. When that's done, just apply the new material to the object and render it again. You can see that the render image has the same texture as the previous image, but in addition, it has the grid that we added. Number 5. Hair Material. The hair material is designed for rendering hair and fur. Let's try it out on this teddy bear right here. First, let's create a new hair material, then you can choose whatever color you want. I'm going with brown in this case. Now apply it to the teddy. and it looks even better now.
It's so fluffy!
And that's all I have for today. If you like my new fluffy teddy bear, smash that like button and subscribe for more videos in the future. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.
Hear what I hear.
But you can see more of the flakes when it's closer. Yo, is that a scratch? What the f-